Hello students, in previous video we have discussed about computer and its generation. In this video we are going to discuss data, informations and components of computer. Data. What is data? So the computer is an electronic device that processes the input according to the set of instructions and gives the desired output. So what computer does, it takes a input from the outside world. Whatever inputs you give, that will be taken and process it. Process means performing a calculations or manipulations or executing. So some operations will be done on that input based on the instructions you give. So we have to give an instruction. What kind of operation is supposed to do? So we have to give the instructions. So based on that instructions, the computer perform the operation on that data and gives the final result. That final result is called as a output. So instruction is nothing but commands. What you have to do, like that, giving a command to the computer is called as the instruction. Our teacher and parents are giving an instruction to you. So once you go to the school, so once a teacher enters into the classroom, so she start to instruct you, take a textbook, take a classwork and start to write the test or start to write out some particular question like this. So these are the instruction. When you group all the instructions together, it becomes a program. So like this, we are instructing a computer to perform it. Okay, so based on that instruction only the computer performs the operation. For example, I'm just giving a and b as a two input. I want to perform the addition, so I'll give the instruction as a plus b. So based on this instruction, the computer perform the addition between a and b and gives the final result. So it not only it stores the data, it also do multiple tasks, whether forecasting, booking a tickets in airlines, railway and movie tickets. For all these things it needs a data. So data is nothing but unprocessed collection of raw factors called as a data. So I already told you that process means performing the calculation. Unprocessed means fresh collection of raw factors called as a data. Collecting your names, it is not processed. Collecting your subject marks, it is not processed. I'm just collecting it. All these details are the fresh. Nothing I've done on it. No operations have done on it. That is called as a fresh raw fact. So these fresh raw fact can be suitable for communications, interpretations or processing. So you can use it for communication wise and you can interpret the data, translate the data or you can perform the operation. Example 134, no meaning at all. 134 is what? Is it a number or is it a mark or what is it? No meaning. By getting a data, it never gives you the some conclusions, never gives you the meaning. It is a raw fact. So the computer collects the data from the outside world and take it as an input. Informations. So how the informations will be created? So information is a collection of facts from which conclusions may be drawn. So always information give the meaning. So how do you get information? From the data only. When the data is processed, it gives you the meaningful information. So it gives you the information. So we have to collect the data and we have to do process on the data and it gives you the information. Example, Kavita is 16 years old. When I say the name Kavita, age 16, no meaning. But when I perform operation, when I combine these data together, it gives you the meaning. The another example, for example, I am collecting your marks. So all your marks are called as a data. So when I connect your 5 subject marks, it is only the data. Nothing I have done on it, no meaning at all. But when I perform the addition on your marks, when I'm finding the total of 5 subjects, the total gives you the meaning. The total is called as the information. Collection of mark is called as a input. Performing the addition is the process, and the final total is the information. So computer is an electronic device that takes a raw data. It takes a raw data, unprocessed data, as an input from the user and process it based on the set of instruction and produces the result, that is the output. So input, so whatever inputs you give, that goes to the process. So it performs operations on the inputs and finally it gives you the output. That output is the information. So input would be the raw fact of data, and that will be processed based on the set of instructions and finally will get a output. One real world example is apple. Take apple as an input, raw fact. It is a raw fruit, nothing we have done. So when I process it, how do I process? I will grind it. When I grind it, what I will get? I will get a output as a apple juice. So apple is a input, grinding is a process, and apple juice is the output. So apple is also called as a data, and grinding is a process, and the juice is the information. Always all the input will be data, output will be the information. Components of computer. So the components of computers are plays an important role here. Without this, there is no computer at all. So computer is a combination of hardware and software. What is hardware? All the physical component of the computer is called as a hardware. All the parts of the computer, internal parts of your computer, all the external parts of the computer, everything is called as a hardware. The example is motherboard, memory devices, monitor, keyboard, all these are called as a hardware. Software. So what do you mean by software? Set of program is called as a software. So program is nothing but set of instruction is called as a software. I told you what is instruction. Instruction is nothing but command. When you group all the commands together, that becomes a program. In computer, everything is a programized one. So whatever we do, there is a program. There is a program to execute your instruction. When I type something in a keyboard, there is a program to read whatever keys you have pressed. That keys will be taken as an input. Even to display it on the monitor also, there is a program for everything. For each and every work, there is a program inside the computer to perform. So the program is nothing but set of instruction. So each instructions are instructing the computer to perform the particular task. Both hardware and softwares working together. So without a hardware, software cannot work alone. Without a software, hardware cannot work alone. So both has to be worked together to make a computer to function. Functional component of computer. So how the computer will work. So every task given to a computer follows an input process output cycle. This is called as the IPO cycle. So it takes the input from the outside world, process the input, and it gives you the output. This is called as the IPO cycle. So the input, we can give input through the input device, for example keyboard. So through this keyboard we can give the data as well as the instruction, that is a program, to the computer. And everything or each data and instruction will be processed in the CPU. The CPU is the central processing unit which process all your data as well as the instructions, and the final output will be displayed in the monitor. So output would be what? It is the information. So data can be given through your input device, and the CPU is a process unit which process all your data based on the instruction and gives the information as a output. So input unit takes the input, central process unit process the data, output unit produces the output. So memory unit holds the data. So the comparison between the human and computers. So as a human, we too have a input parts, output parts and processing parts also. So whatever we see, that can be vision, that vision is assigned through, accept through your eyes. So your eyes is acting as input device. Once you saw particular image, that image will be stored in your brain. So it processes it. Then when I ask what you saw in that particular page, so you will collect it from the brain and you will express through your mouth or your writing it on your paper using your hand. So your mouth and hand is acting as a output part. So the which is a processing here, your brain is the processing. See, for example, the computer, which is a input of computer, keyboard, mouse, process is the CPU, output is the monitor or speaker. When I give some instruction, when I say 2 plus 3, so 2 plus 3, 2 and 3 are the data. 2 plus 3 is the instruction. All these data and instruction will be given to the computer through the input device and process. CPU, it processes the data 2 and 3 based on the instruction 2 plus 3. So it performs all the calculation and it displays the answer 5 in the monitor. That is, the 5 is the information, 2 and 3 are the data, and plus is the instruction. So 5 will be information, that is output will be displayed. So if it is a human, when you say 2 plus 3, you can hear this value through your ears or you can see the values through your eyes. So ear and eyes will be acting as an input device. Then which part will process everything? Our brain. So when I say 2 plus 3, immediately your brain started to perform the calculation. So your brain will calculate your answers. And when I ask you to tell the answers, you can say it through your mouth. So the mouth is also acting as a output device, or you can write it on the paper also. So your hand is acting as a another output device. So like this, how human are reacting based on the concept, the computer is also designed here. So we too have a input, process and output. Components of computers, how the computer work here. So this is the exact functional unit of your computer. So input unit, so input unit gets a data from the user and it directly stores into the main memory. All your thick red line determines your transaction of your data. The data is transferred like this. All your dashed lines, this dashed line tells the control given by the control unit. So whatever data is given, so that will be accept. This input unit feed the data from the input devices and feed the data into the main memory. So whatever input unit collects, that stores into the main memory. Then your CPU, this is your CPU, which sees your data and instructions. All that will be transferred into the internal memory in your CPU. So then it see that if there is any calculations, ALU will perform the calculations here. So ALU is nothing but arithmetic logical unit, which is used to perform all the calculations, mathematical and logical calculations. So internally they are using a temporary memory to hold the values, result as well as the input also. It see that if there is any data to be calculated, any mathematical calculations have to be done. If there is any mathematical calculations, ALU perform the calculation and it stores the result. Then finally your result will reach your output unit. Okay, how all these things are happening, how each one knows how to, when to transfer, when to perform the calculation, when to transfer the data to the output unit, All these things are happened with the help of the control unit. Control unit is nothing but which controls the operation of all the unit. That is called as a control unit. So can you see this dashed line? So the dashed lines indicates that control given to the input unit. First, the control unit instructs the input unit to send a data to the main memory. Then control unit instructs a main memory to send a data to the internal memory. Then again, control unit instructs ALU to check whether is there any calculations have to be done. Then if it is there, control unit instructs ALU, that is internal memory, to give a data to the ALU. So ALU perform the calculations and it instructs ALU to return a value to the internal memory. Again, it instructs here internal memory to send a data to the main memory, that is result to the main memory. So for then again the control unit instructs a main memory to send a data to the output unit. Control unit instructs a output unit to display the informations to the user. This is a working principle of the computer. For example, when I give 2 plus 3, so the 2 plus 3 is read by the input unit. The 2 plus 3 will be stored in the main memory. So the control unit instructs a main memory to send a data to the internal memory. In internal memory, 2 plus 3 will be stored here. So there is a addition operation is here. So ALU perform the additional operation. So the answer is 5. 5 is sent it back to the internal memory. Again it sent it back to the main memory. Control unit instructs a main memory to send a result to the output unit. So the 5 is transferred to the output unit. So output unit displays the answer in the output device. What is input unit and output unit? So already we have studied. So input unit is nothing but it is used to feed any form of data to the computer. It can be any kind of data. It can be the text or number or images or any video, audios or anything. Any kind of data can be fed it into the computer and it can be stored in the memory unit. So what are the examples of input units? Keyboard, mouse, light pen, many input devices are there. We will study it later. Then output unit. What is output unit? The output unit gives the result to the user. So whatever result we get, that will be displayed on the output devices. It's an hardware component that conveys information to the user in an understandable form. So whatever human can understand, in that format your data will be displayed. Example of output units are monitor and printer. Central processor unit. What is central processing unit? The CPU. The CPU is also called as the brain of the computer because see how it is compared to the human being. So human can be live, can think and do everything with the help of a brain. Without a brain, the man cannot live. Similarly, without a CPU, the computer cannot do anything. So CPU is the brain of the computer. So it performs, it is a major component which interprets and executes the software instruction. It controls all the operations of all other components. So overall activities um control pandrathu vandu CPU. It just control all the operations of each unit. It accepts a binary data as an input. So whatever data we give, that data are understandable by the human being. But computer can understand only zeros and one. So that data will be converted into machine language and process the data based on the instruction and provides a result in the understandable form to the user. So the CPU has three components. What are the three components? Control unit, arithmetic and logical unit, and memory unit. So ALU and control unit. So already we have discussed about the input unit and output unit. Now ALU1 control unit. ALU is nothing but arithmetic and logical unit which is used to perform the calculation. ALU is the part of the CPU. So in the CPU itself we have a ALU control unit and memory unit. Okay, so it is a part of the CPU where all your calculations have to be performed. It can perform arithmetic operations such as addition, subtraction, multiplication, division and logical operations. So the result of the operations are stored in the internal memory. We saw it in that functional unit. Okay, so everything will be stored in the internal memory of CPU, and it also do the decision making ability of a computer also. Then control unit. So we saw that now what control unit does, it controls all the operations of the unit. It controls the flow of data between the CPU, memory and IO devices. Only control unit gives the instructions, give the signal to the input units to send the data to the main memory, and from that it goes to the ALU part, perform the calculation, again it goes to the output devices. So it controls entire transactions among the units. It also controls the entire operation of computer. Memory unit. So what is memory unit? Memory unit which is used to store the data. So unit itself, memory is divided into two parts, that is primary memory and secondary memory. What is primary memory? Primary memory is used to store all your data in the temporary mode. Okay, so whatever data are stored in the primary memory, that is all temporary memory only. It never stores any data as in permanent mode. So primary memory is used to temporarily store the programs and data when the instructions are ready to execute. Whatever instructions are ready to execute, that will be in the primary memory. So in an RAM is an example of primary memory. For example, when you are doing some work in your computer, whatever applications you have opened, all your applications will be stored in the RAM only. So it is not storing all applications permanently, it is storing it for temporary purpose only. When you close that application, automatically it will be vanished from the memory. So primary memory is a volatile, that is the content is lost when the power supply is switched off. So when you are working, you are just doing some painting in the MS Paint. When you open MS Paint, MS Paint will be stored temporarily in the RAM. When you are drawing some object, so that is also temporarily stored over there. Suddenly when the power goes off, what will happen? Whatever you have done it in that will be lost. Okay, that will be lost. That is a primary memory. It is a volatile. It never stores any data as a permanent. Whichever programs are ready to execute, all that programs temporarily will be stored in the main memory. So random access memory, RAM, is an example of main memory. Secondary memory, which is used to store the data in the permanent mode. Whatever data you are storing in the secondary memory, it is stored in the permanent. Example, hard disk, pen drive, floppy disk and CD, all these are called as a secondary memory. Many examples are there. So when you, once you have stored in the secondary memory, it will not be erased, it will be saved in the permanent, it will never deleted also until you delete. So the secondary memory is called as a non-volatile memory. So the content is available even power supply is switched off. As I told you, when you open a MS Paint will be stored in the RAM as a temporary data. When you are drawing some object, once you have drawn, you have saved it. Where do you save? You will be saved in data in the hard disk. So hard disk is the secondary memory. Once it is saved, even when the power goes off also, your image will not be deleted. It will be saved in the hard disk. Do you understand that? If you have not saved, means it will be temporarily stored in the RAM, so primary memory. So automatically it will be erased when you switch off your computer. So in your application you open panita work panita irukringlo adu temporary primary memory la store aagum. Current off aachna automatically whatever data stored in the primary memory will be erased if you have not saved. But when you are saving, save panamod enna agum, whatever data you are saving, that will be saved in the secondary memory. Example of secondary memory is hard disk. Default avi nammaloada computer enna irukum, hard disk irukum. Namma save pandrad ellame vandu it will be stored in the hard disk only. So hard disk is an example of secondary memory. So it is a non volatile memory. Non volatile memory means it will not be erased, it will be stored as a permanent one. Even when the power goes off also, it will not be erased. Your object drop pani mudichin once save panita adu unoda hard disk la save aayirukum. Ipa current off ana kuda ee save panna anda object anda image vandu delete agada. This is secondary memory. Students, now you could understand what is data, informations and working principle of computer. In the next class, we'll discuss about the input devices and output devices. Thank you.